Hey, happy Thursday, everybody. So let's get right into the show. A lot of people have been talking about how they have really kicked it up a notch this season on The Bachelor.
Well, the women have taken, let's say, maybe an outrageous approach.
That's an understatement.
Yes, and in the center of the storm is The Bachelor himself. I actually got a chance to talk with him about it all, but first, take a look at this clip from the show.
Last night was kind of crazy, formal. So let's have a pool party.
This is like a dream.
Just continues to amaze me how lucky I am right now.
I have never been on a date with 5 other girls. This is kind of crazy, but I'm here for Chris, so I'll take it.
Marga.
This is an awesome first date. I didn't know how the dynamic of 6 girls and 1 guy was going to be.
Okay, I win.
And it's just exciting to be taking things to the next level today.
Now, millions of single women were probably happy to see Chris Soules, the stylish farmer, was sent home during The Bachelorette. Now they had a chance with him. And as we saw in the season premiere of The Bachelor, 30 ladies really did whatever it took to grab his attention. Now, Chris joins me to talk about sending some of those ladies home and looking for love. And Chris, of course, we saw everything from karaoke to lace outfits and even a little bleeped out words during that first season premiere.
Yes, it was an interesting first night.
And so I'm sure now that, you know, America has seen that first night, a lot of people are kind of asking you some questions about your choices. Did you think you were going to kind of get that reaction from everyone?
You know, I didn't really know what to expect. But I've definitely gotten lots of questions about some of my decisions, which I am fully, I have no regrets, honestly, after the first night.
And so do you kind of follow your heart, or do you think, you know, my family's watching, what are they going to think, America's watching, what's your real reason to give the roses?
I did the best I could. You know, I didn't get to talk to all 30 women, but when I did, you know, the ones that I did talk to, I, you know, got a first impression of, you know, that I was either was wanting to move forward with them or felt like, you know, there was just didn't see it going anywhere. So I went with my gut in all the decisions I made throughout the entire process.
I mean, you don't usually date, you know, 30 women at one time. That's not a normal thing in your daily life. I'm sure it's something you had to get used to.
Yeah, it's definitely something you have to get used to. And I knew what I was getting myself into. And I kind of, you know, going through The Bachelorette, you kind of understand how to try to really focus on the relationship and try to block out the fact that there's, you know, in that situation, obviously there's 25 other guys, and this now there's reverse. And so I've really had to focus on each individual woman and try to focus on the potential that could be there for us going forward and focus on the things that I could see in them, you know, and did I see if there was a future between us, you know? So you really had to just take every second that we got to spend with each individual girl and think about, do I see a future with this woman?
Well, I know some people had some questions about Tara, and of course we saw a real connection with you and Britt, but I know you can't tell me who it is, even though I'm dying to know what happens at the end, but I'm just going to kind of fast forward. What happens? Do you ever think, you know, these women don't live in the same town as I? Will they move? Will I move? Do you think that far in advance?
Going into this, I was looking at first finding my soulmate, I think. You know, I think that's the main goal, is if I can find her, you know, then I think compromise is the next step in figuring out whether or not where our future is going to be, you know, where we're going to live and that sort of thing. And, you know, obviously I was always going to be a big part of my life and a place that I'm going to need to be at to continue my career, but, you know, I'm willing to compromise, and maybe, you know, if we can move to moving to a city is a part of that, then I'm open to that. But, you know, my number one goal is to fall in love and then start having those discussions, you know, and I fortunately in this situation, you get that opportunity.
Well, Chris, I know everyone's going to be on pins and needles this season to see what happens. And just to let you know, the ladies here in our station say if you ever come by Arizona and you're still looking for love, they're ready to meet with you as well. So I want to thank you for taking some time here with us.
I will keep that in mind. Thanks. Thanks for having me, Tina.
Thanks so much, Chris. Watch it all unfold for Chris every Monday night right here on KGN 9 ABC. The Bachelor airs at 7 p.m. Don't go anywhere. The Morning Blend will be right back.